Reading the text. Captain Rosa, there she is. Hey, Matt, thank you for the 9 months. Good to see you. Happy Sunday. Like the Rosa Dark Knight sprite, it's cool. The Baron music. Oh, that Bagan. I think that guy is a troublemaker. Thank you. Get in line, Captain Rosa. Ooh, disobedience. Ooh, damn. No trust in one who offers none in return. What's in the box? That's right, I think we can sprint now. I thought... Maybe not until later? Oh yeah. That's nice. Okay, how did I do that? Okay, you tap L, and then you can... Cool, that's helpful. Training rooms. We know how to play this game. We don't need to talk to all these. We could check these pots though. There's treasures down there. Are there treasures down there? Or that's where... Here we go. Aw. It's Cecil! Thank you. Hey, Sid! Aw, I love Sid. Such a great character. I just love the sprites in this game. They're so amazing. Nice comfy bed for Rosa. It's okay, Rosa. Sometimes you get put in an impossible situation. I just love this. Cecil's Because, you know, usually this is Cecil's the Dark Knight, and Rose is like, oh, Cecil, why? I love the gender swap, it's so great. A black heart on my necklace, so I understand, Rosa. It's okay. Yeah, there's definitely some changes in the translation. The vanilla says a mist dragon, it changed it to Esper. So this hack is actually a fork of another hack that I'm not familiar with. I'm guessing in the hack that it forks from, it changed some of the text. Hey, Leflo, happy Sunday. Welcome in. Soundtrack in this game is too good. It's too good. All right, here we go. Oh, this opening soundtrack. Thank you. like that word, avarice. What does that mean? Must be mean something along the lines of like conflict or greed or... I love that line of text. Crystals silently shed their light. It's really pretty. In a somber kind of way. The best overworld music. Alright, like the start of any good RPG. Let's save. Alright, hopefully the save functionality works okay. Yep, we're good. Alright, let's check out the village. Go there yet. Who is it? Sid's house? Is Sid asleep? Yeah, he's snoozing. I love that so much. First dancer. I love the dancers. Oh no, she took her clothes off! Lol. I think the original Final Fantasy IV, the dancers take their clothes off, and then they patch that out for the US version, since we always get the sanitized versions of games. So of course, like a good ROM hacker, you restore all the original goodies. So there you go! Changing the item names, that's a little weird. Stop trap? Not quite sure what that will do. Guessing it's probably some sort of like offensive item. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna keep the talking to a minimum. My goal then is to highlight all these videos and have them in a collection. So that, I mean, this is such a cozy game that people can watch them at their leisure, like while they work or pay bills or do chores, and it can be like a nice kind of ASMR background thing. Very chill. Yeah, I don't think we need anything else. This is a pretty light opener. I've been playing Final Fantasy II J, and that game is hard as nails. So this game should be a welcome alternative to that. Alright, here we go. The first battle. Yeah, Luffo, let me know how, excuse me, the audio balance is with like game audio and mic, because the Super Nintendo is super loud. So I had to change my settings versus when I play NES. I'm definitely okay with the sound being on the louder side. I just don't want it to be too quiet. Let's turn battle speed up. Active. Okay, it's better. Okay, cool. Thanks, Luffo. All right, on to the Mist Cave. I love it. Oh, it's so pretty. Like, I just... Oh, this game is so pretty. I love early 16-bit. I guess maybe because, you know, I'm such an NES fan. Early 16-bit is like 8-bit, which is like an extra little oof to it. In terms of the visuals, obviously the audio is very different. Probably cast stop. Yeah, stop. Oh, cool. That's a nice item. Especially because it attacks all the monsters. I'm definitely a completionist when it comes to getting my treasure boxes. It's one of my favorite things to do. I love getting all the treasures. Characters in RPGs. I just love his jump attack. It's so cool. It's such a cool move. Ooh, Rosa up a level. Let's go. Yeah, their favorite thing to do in RPGs is to organize my items. Partner always teases me about. If I'm doing something in IRL, she'd be like, are you organizing your items right now? It's really cute. Yes, I am. Alright, she's looking good. One more item to grab. Part is really heartbreaking. Well, if we want to keep playing this game, we have to say yes. So, here we go. How many times have I murdered Rydia's mom? I've been playing this game since I was 10. 41, so. Many times. Spoiler alert! The mist is coalescing. There's just so many, like, poetic moments in this game. Not want to attack when the dragon is in mist form. Battle theme. So good. This is like the mid-tier boss theme, because the four fiends have their own boss music, right? Alright, there's the Mist Dragon. Onward we go. Let's unequip Kane. That way we can sell all of his treasures. All of his equipment. Sorry, Kane, you're naked. Ugh. Those evil little bombs. Thank you. you go, Rosa. And we take our first step to the light. It's awesome. Call Titan. Let us have it. God, this game is so tight. Like, it's this game is rarely boring. Like, it keeps it moving. It's so fun. Is that like too much narrative? Is that really like a lot of level grinding? All alone. Right. I'm a slow reader, so I feel like by the time I click through the text, anybody who wants to read it probably has. I'll still try to go slow though. Thank you. let's go. Gonna be Cecil who's gonna have fallen from desert fever. We found this barren man outside town. Aww, Cecil, it's okay, baby. Aww. That's so sweet. Aww. I'm getting misty-eyed. I guess we better go get ourselves a sand ruby. Let's go. Oh, we can sprint in the overworld too. That's awesome. That'll make things a little less tedious. I think the only spell Rydia knows to start is... She doesn't know any spells, but she can't call a chocobo. Yeah, it's cool. Have you seen us cure? She might know cure. It's cool that she, as a child, knows black and white magic. Now we know ice. And now we know cure. That's good. Oh, that was easy. Watery underpass. Maiden kiss. I think that helps. What does that help with? Oh, Cure's Toad. It's telling me right there. Thank you, game. For the water cave. And, oh, we almost made it to Tella. Almost made it to Tella. Ooh, back attack. Oh, that's not good for Radio. She's gonna get wrecked up there. Hey, Somburger. Happy Sunday. Welcome in. Cures Mini. There we go. Tella. I love Tella. He's a great character. Very powerful. Oops. It's recall. Interesting. What does that do? Oh, that's an add-on. That's neat. It's probably like a random roll of the dice, and he'll cast one of his old forgotten spells. It's cool. Oh, not Toad. Sauce, what's up? Welcome in. Happy Sunday. Just doing a little Final Fantasy IV ROM hack playthrough. Nice, we got a life potion. This ROM hack sees, I don't know if you're familiar with Final Fantasy IV or not. I imagine you are, since I know you seem like you're a big Super Nintendo person. But Rosa and Cecil are flipped. So we have Dark Knight Cecil with us, or Dark Knight Rosa with us right now. Nice, nice. Well, this is a great game. It's very cozy. It's got great music. Thank you. excited. Alright, our first indoor safe spot. Oh, they changed it from an S. What is it? Is that a pentagram now? Yeah, enjoy the vibe, Sauce. My hope is, like I said, I'm keeping kind of the talking at a minimum. So I'll highlight all of these sessions and put them in a collection. And hopefully people can use it as like a ASMR. Now why'd the zombie come up? We don't want zombie. You go on, there we go. Yeah, people can kinda have them on in the background while they work and stuff like that. Kind of cozy playthrough. Nice change of pace from speedrunning. Treasure box. Oh well. I'm not going back for it. You'll survive. Stronger. Oh boy. Oh no, not the tiny mage. The mini mage. Those little dudes are pretty tough, actually. Can be. Oh no. Thank you. my MP. That's not very nice. Yeah, because those mini mages are tough. That was a tough battle. Actually, no, I'd rather do this. Forgot about those pod mods. We use some of those to make these battles a little easier. Should at least be able to get through the antlion cave today. It'd be cool to be able to get through Fabul. I don't know. We'll see. Charm. There are definitely some monsters you encounter later in this adventure who use charm. They are tough. What does this do? Notice. Huh. That's different. There's some different stuff in this that I've never seen before. Huh. know there's some notes with the ROM hack. I'll have to look some of this stuff up. It must be a weapon, would be my guess. Like a offensive item. Yeah, let's find out. Ooh, it's ice. That was rad. I love the background there. I just always thought that was so pretty. Sword for Rosa. Shadow Sword. All right, a little respite. It's a cute emote, Songbreaker. Alright. Yeah, the overworld music in this game is some of my favorite. It's very pretty. I know. Alright, here we go. Mini mages are a pain in the butt. I don't run very much when I play RPGs, but those mini mages are... they're a bit much. Alright, some new armor. It's cool. great on those alligators. Right, Rydia's learning all the spells. Let's go. Now, it's so funny. So, I mean, I played this game when it came out, you know, originally 30 years ago, 31 years ago. And then when Final Fantasy III US slash 6 came out and you met your tentacle friend, Ultros, isn't that his name? The octopus, Ultros? So I thought Ultros was like, oh my god, it's the octopus monster from Final Fantasy II. But now I think when I fight this guy, it's like, oh, it's Ultros. So Ultros won in my my memories. Octo-Man. Ooh, dark. I forget what that does. I forgot that I could use that. Oh, that's right, but it reduces Rose's health. Okay, let's use Josh, yeah, we're on Octo-Man now. I know, I love Rosa as the Dark Knight. It's so cool. It's so cool. Happy Sunday, though. Hope you're having a good one so far. There it is. Yeah, this seems like a good place for a break. Get up and stretch a little bit. Oh, cool, Josh. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight all of these sessions, and then I'll put them in a collection on my channel called, you know, Final Fantasy IV Playthrough. And I'm keeping all of the, not reading any text, and I'm keeping my chat to, you know, me to a minimum. So that way they're, like, kind of nice and cozy, so you can pull them up and listen to them when you're working or paying bills or doing chores or whatever. So they'll be there for you to watch whenever you get the chance. But thanks for coming by. Have a great day. We took Quinny to the park earlier, so it's beautiful here in Chicagoland. Hope it is out your way, too. Alright, y'all, I'm gonna save and leave you with this pretty overworld music and go stretch my legs. And I think we've got some drama about to unfold. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, we are back. Continue on our journey. We should unequip Tella. No, Tella doesn't really have anything. And you don't really get to keep Tella for very long this first stint, do you? Oh, this part is heartbreaking. Here we go. Damn red wings. So, oh my god, the soundtrack in this game is so pretty. So pretty. Oh, you're welcome, Leflo. Thanks for coming by. Have a great rest of your day. Is unhinged. Oh, here comes that famous line. Took his staff away. There it is, you spoony bard. Is that a spoon emote? Shut your damn. It's harsh. That's hilarious. Aw, there's Anna. Oh, I love Edward's theme too. Edward's a great character. He's sort of like gender bending in the vanilla, right? Because like he's very emotional, and so he's seen as like feminine and weak. Then like he finds his own courage and he finds his own ways to contribute. It's very interesting that he ends up in that kingdom that's ruled by women. And that it's in that kingdom where he finds that like his, you know, that femininity, or what's seen as femininity, could also be strong. Because right there, they're ruled by women and all the warriors are women. And he finds that strength, doesn't have shame in who he is anymore. And that's when he steps up and saves your party. So, pretty darn cool. That's right, we talk about gender on this channel. I would like to do that more often, but maybe this game will be a catalyst. What did the five fingers say to the face? we don't need to go back to capo. Oh, Sauce, thank you for your comment. No worries at all. No worries at all. You're good. You are good, but thank you. All right, we got the hovercraft. I love the hovercraft. It's such a cool little vehicle. I think there's some goodies back at the, Oh, yeah, 100% all good. More than all good. 150%. Yeah, I'm sorry if, sometimes when it comes to gender, and like pronouns and things like that, I personally kind of try to keep it somewhat lighthearted. I know that not everybody's always familiar with folks who use they/them pronouns or things like that. Sorry if that came. Okay, yeah, I was worried if that came across harshly and caused you any stress. Yeah, I find when it comes to gender and really any kind of identity, the people who care, I mean, caring is like, it's first and foremost, right? I mean, none of us get through life without stepping on one another's toes in different ways. You know, as a white person and growing up and going through life and having friends, people of color, I've certainly have said awkward things at times, and people have always been very gentle with me, so yeah, gotta be gentle with each other. But yeah, we all good. Glad you're here. What was I doing? Oh, yeah. Edward has, the bard robe. Okay, so. Now, I'm pretty sure there's some goodies back here. Yeah, that's right. They like to do sneak it on you. There's one tile before you go back in there. Bit of a language barrier. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. Like, I know in some languages, you know, things are sort of, you know, masculine and feminine in terms of, like, words. And some languages, I know that people who are, like, non-binary or looking for gender-neutral ways of expressing things can have a hard time finding a way to phrase words or find words that aren't gendered by nature. And that's the thing that's kind of fun, though, about being non-binary. Like, it's fine that words are gendered. I think what it kind of comes down to it is, it's like this game, right? You know, just because someone is born into a particular kind of body means that, you know, we should have certain kinds of expectations about them, you know, with language, gender roles, their relationship to their emotions, what kind of clothes they wear. So, like, in the original, like, okay, Rosa is assigned female at birth, and she identifies as a woman, so, of course, she's going to be the one in distress. She's going to be the white magic user. She's going to be, like, the motherly, you know, kind of character just because of the body she's in. Like, that's ridiculous. I mean, people are in... The bodies that people are in shouldn't determine, like, their whole life in front of them. So it's kind of, you can be kind of playful with language, you know, like use feminine words where you might normally use masculine words, or use masculine words in the space where you might normally use a feminine word. That's what I really like about gender and language, like messing with it. You know, gay men have done that for ages. They call each other girl and things like that. Kind of mess with the language of it. Yeah, because at the end of the day, I mean, all language is made up. And language is there for us to describe our experiences of ourselves and one another, and to try to connect with one another. Language is always changing and expanding, and, you know, going out of date. Well, hey, you, the creativity is interesting. I like creative things. Okay, oh my gosh. So we have all these items to organize now. Really kind of fun is I was reading the notes on this ROM hack, and the idea for this, not from the actual person who created the ROM hack, but somebody in a gender studies class, like, wrote a paper or an essay or something about this game, and kind of, like, proposed, like, what would it be like if you swapped Rosa and Cecil? And then the person, the author of the ROM hack, heard about that, probably like on a Final Fantasy board or something like that, and was like, oh, that idea is really interesting, I should do that. let's go visit the Antlion Cave. We good? We are organized? We got a lot of stuff to sell. Oh, do you? That's cool. This music is in Kaizo's. This game has a great soundtrack. I just love it so much. So I'm playing on a Super NT, so hardware emulation, and it's on an SD card. I guess I just save on all slots out of habit. That's funny. Yeah, I just like do it because I mean I've been playing this game for 30 years. It's funny though. I guess we don't really need to do that, though, huh? Oh, I hate these things. They just suck up all your resources. Well, no, that's right. Rydia doesn't know fire yet. She doesn't want to know it. Ooh, bolt works nicely, though. Okay, what are we doing here? That's terrible. That's a shame. Yeah, that's what's nice about playing on a any kind of emulation, whether it's software or hardware. You don't have to worry about bad battery backup. Treasures off to the left, but eh, whatever. We can check them on the way out. Thank you. shot, Edward. The charm harp now. It's a cool weapon. It's a really cool weapon. Oh my gosh, all the enemies. Yes, remember, we can use bolts. Deadly as earlier Final Fantasies. To turn you to stone and your character is stuck like that. Ooh, exit door. That's very generous. Very cool. That's an add-on. It was always a pain to get out of this dungeon. You didn't have exit yet. I think sometimes I would use... Sometimes Rydia would have warp at this point. Then you can get out. Yeah, so she doesn't have warp yet. Well, thanks, Sauce. Enjoy the day. It is very pretty in Chicagoland. Hope it is up by you. Thanks for hanging out. Good to see ya. We have our exit door. It'll make it much easier on us to get out of here. really well against those enemies. Right, here we go. Love this part. Careful, Edward. I don't know, buddy. I don't think Antlion is tame anymore. Easy peasy. Let's go. Let's go cure Cecil. Alright, out we go. We can use our exit door. A little bit easier. What? Enemy camped on our, I was gonna run. Yeah, stupid mini mages. Guys are mean. Gotcha, boo. I always loved Cecil's Lunarian hair, like blue, gray. It's really pretty. Aww. Oh, just, oh my god, it's so sweet. The role reversal? Oh my gosh, you're meaning like misty-eyed. It's so sweet. I kind of like that. It's a very kind of circular, like, that points back to the vanilla game too. Like, you're not finishing that quest without Rosa. I like that. Oh, fine, Cecil. You man. You emotional man. It's so good. It's so good. Oh, I love this part too. I love that sprite of Edward playing the harp. I just think that's really cool. That's a really cool sprite. You got this, Edward. Let's go. Right, Edward. Good job. Heck yeah. And a level up. That's right, Edward leveled up there. Aw. Sorry, Edward. I know you love Anna. Aw. Very touching. Not for you to know yet, Edward. Sell some stuff. Nice. Yeah, I'm thinking if we can get through Fabul, so where Rosa will wash up on the Mycidian shore, that seems like a good stopping place for today. We've made some good progress. There, our hovercraft will stay until, yeah, we're ready to go to Eblon. This part's cool. Let's go. Nice. Good job, Rydia. Is there a safe spot there already? Like, we just entered. We don't need a safe spot. It's very generous. It's weird seeing the Cecil sprite. At this point in the game. Going 150 health. I thought that guy used fire, maybe, give him health. Nice to have a, white wizard, though. We'll be right back. toad. A spell I never really use, but hey, it's okay. I like this part. Oh, that's a trip seeing those two next to each other. It's Yang! Hi-ya! Bomb bomb. Alright, first time we have a full party. I love that character. Mom Bomb's looking mean. It's kind of low. Character. He gets a lot of hate, but he's a great character. I love him. Nice job, everybody. That's not good. Go. We'll be right back. always having a full party. Background. I love early Super Nintendo. It's my favorite. We won't have a full party again until... Do we have a full party for Kanaza? Yeah, because you have, I'll have Rosa and Yang. And Tella and the twins. All those enemies, holy smokes. We'll be right back. almost there. Almost. I always really enjoy this upcoming sequence. Like the idea of like defending the castle. It's really cool. Shop up? Really? That's kind of sweet. So we can get Yang another claw. I didn't realize you could hit the shop up before the battle. That is very helpful. Defend the castle. Thank you. How fares Dan Sienna? Well, it's that doing something. Horse one. That's what we're here for. Sir, you're a white wizard. You and the young girl kindly aid our healers. I feel like in the vanilla, it says something like that. We help the women, or something like that. Yeah, we're not gonna see Cecil for a while. He's gonna get kidnapped, taken to the Tower of Zot. Have at them. Oh, we will. We will. Let's go. Na-na-na-na-na-na. Damn. These guys hit hard. Help you, Captain. Nice. Left to do is draw the enemy near and crush them. So awesome. A baddie. Just one gargoyle. We'll be right back. Oh no, Edward trips. Gotta get our boy Edward. Let's go. You're fine, buddy. Get on your feet. Let's go. Any of the captains, they all ran on us. Alright, here's the crystal room. Oh, that was a good defense. Oh no, it's Kane! Traitor. Rosa's getting wrecked. Oof. There's our first. Oh, there's our first Kane and Cecil. Bromance interaction. Aww. Oh boy. Who's the bigger bad? Golbez or Kefka? Oh boy, I don't know. That's a tough one. Kefka's pretty evil. But Golbez, when he's fully under Zemus's control, is also very evil. All the characters have like their own theme song for the most part. Is this man important to you? Oh my god, I love this. I love this ROM hack. It's so interesting how the world is when you just kind of move the chess pieces over one tile. Everything changes. Boy, we've gotten our butt kicked, haven't we? Lost the fire crystal. We went and captured the water crystal. Lost the fire crystal. Did our best to defend Fabul and lost the wind crystal. Cecil got captured. Our best friend kicked our butt. Oof. Definitely a low for the party. No, we have each other though. Thank you. treasures here. Yeah, I could play this all day. I love this game so much. Alas, I think today's journey is about over. Who that Dark Knight was. The Dark Knight left it here long ago. I wonder if it's Final Fantasy 2 or 3 suggests who that Dark Knight was. Ooh, the Doom Sword. I like that they updated that it used to be called the Black Sword. Like, black is evil and white is good. I'm glad they updated that. That's those tropes, there you go, there's an example of language that needs to be updated. I think this dancer takes off her clothes. Da, da, da. Oh no, turns into a dude, it's right. Talk about gender bending. I love that. There, we gotta make sure to go see Yang's wife before we depart. I was like visiting her. And there's treasures over here. I love me some treasures. Hemingway's in bed. Poor Hemingway. You gotta get that frying pan later. It's an important item. Sword. We don't need it anymore. guess we can unequip everybody, huh? You want to lose the whole group. Let's go. It's everybody, right? Yeah. Alright. I'll just run. Alright. On to the ship we go. I love this part. Setting sail for Baron. Will we make it? Something tells me we might have a holdup somewhere. Yang. When do we see Yang? Oh, and Baron. There goes our ship. Okay. Y'all, I think that is gonna do it for today's adventures. So we find ourselves at Mycidia. We were attacked by Leviathan on the way to Baron. So Rosa's not doing so great. Her boo, Cecil, got captured. Her friend, Kane, has flipped and is now a total butthead. There's a new big bad in town, Golbez, and all of her friends fell into the sea. So, what awaits Rosa in the next chapter? These two are the best characters in all of RPGs. That Baron doll. Thank you. could... Okay, whatever. Darn it. Those tiny mages. They're such a pain in the butt. You know what Cry does? Oh goodness, cockatrices are way less scary and this game than old school. Well, this game is old school, but even earlier, Final Fantasy games, because they have the ability to turn you to stone instantly. Ice too, nice. This fight's gonna take forever. Spell animations in this game are definitely probably my favorite in RPGs. I just something about them is really cool. Right, such a short walk to Mount Ordeal. I just love those two so much. I guess especially because we know what's coming. Ooh, meanwhile. Yeah, see, the guillotine is back. Oh no, Cecil. Thank you. Milan's gonna get it done. Face column mix. Thank you. Tella! I like this party a lot. The Dark Knight with the three mages. I like that they left it. I always pronounced it Mateo, but it's Meteor, but they don't have enough characters for the R. So I guess it'd be like Meteo? Meteo? I always call it Mateo, though. So that's what we're gonna call it. You know, Mateo. I love how irreverent Paulum is. The spy on. Oops! Kapow! Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll probably never play the vanilla version of this again. I like Rosa being the hero. She deserves it. She means boyfriend. Pretty short work of everybody now. Oh, I know what we should be using. Thank you. mean to use that. Ooh, that worked. Yeah, did not mean to use that. Again, I just love that background. So pretty. Again, that like that early SNES feels almost more like enhanced 8-bit graphics. Man, we're getting all the random attacks. Earlier caves and stuff are so short. This battle. Cue the FFIV music. Love it. Meal from my undead underlings. Okay then, buddy. Let's roll. Too easy, come on. Pollen is way too strong. Mm-hmm. Oh, really? But you're undead. Okay, whatever. Ouch. Ready for the potato boss now? Yes, well done. There's the boss music. Yeah, I call him the potato boss because it looks like a potato that's been set out for too long and it's got like the things growing out of it. Ouch. So hard. Ba 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 da booty beady. Should have sent Kane, Golbez, because we just dusted your first four fiend. Take that, potato boss. Hello, bloop at the end. Here we go. Oh, I wonder what. Because usually... Yeah, anyways, here we go. Aww. Sweet. I love this so much. Go. Like Dark Rosa hits harder than Dark Knight Cecil. What does that mean? I know what it feels like, Rosa, to not know your dad. I understand. Go, Rosa, go. Heck yeah, it's awesome. We are a very powerful little group of folks now, aren't we? That's what I like about this game. You know, in other games, they give you the freedom to kind of like mix and match your party. And I'm sure that appeals to folks who really like kind of like customization in RPGs. But I like the linearity of this game, and that people come in and out of your party. And that causes me to just sort of like enjoy the party while I have it, and to kind of like, you know, what are the strengths and weaknesses, and kind of just vibe with whatever the game gives me. Uh-oh.